Over half of all children globally suffer from hidden hunger, or one or more forms of deficiencies in vitamins and minerals found in high-quality healthy foods. And when a child lacks these nutrients in the first 1,000 days of life, it can stunt normal growth and brain development. After that, there's no going back. The damage is irreversible. We want to reset the starting clock.
Plátanos tiene.
No.
Tampoco tortillas. Gracias.
Ella se llama Selene Giovanna. El embarazo era de alto riesgo. Cada vez que yo iba al hospital y era el cráneo internada, yo ya perdí un hijo y no quería volver a tener otro hijo. Entonces, ese estrés me ayudó a sobrellevarlo, fue así mi cuna. Mi cuna para mí fue una experiencia muy bonita.
Makuna, we're very interested in studying how a dietary pattern translates into fetus brain development and growth. We collect information that we can later use to influence programming and policy. If we need to reduce rice and increase the variety of other foods, because rice takes up a lot of our energy and calories. And one of the most important things to remember in pregnancy and beyond is diversity. I enjoy working with pregnant women and mothers of young children.
Papa? ¿Dónde está la fruta?
I have three children of my own, and I love that part of my life.
No, gracias.
Most of the time. It's shaped my life's work as an academic and my research questions. In partnership with public health and medical experts from the local university, we started the Makuna Project with a big question in mind. Can we address hidden hunger and influence early brain development, starting with a pregnant woman's diet? We're also interested in which foods are important for mothers to eat. Every week, we give them healthy meals to prepare at home, sourced from nearby farms.
Creo que necesitamos un consumo un poco más consciente. Entonces, es muy importante saber de dónde provienen cada producto de los que consumimos en nuestros hogares.
Esto es de Ecuador, Nacional.
Nacional de Ecuador. Cada huevo es una huella digital de cada gallina. Y yo creo que esta conexión que ustedes hicieron con el proyecto les ayuda también a conectarse entre mujeres, mujeres de la sierra, mujeres de la Amazonía.
Need to consider the cultural preferences for foods, but also the foods that are already in the environment that people can access at affordable prices. You want to ensure that these foods will be available when your research project is over and that it's practical or feasible to imagine that this could be scaled up into practice and policy.
Entre más natural sea, ayuda mejor el desarrollo del cerebro.
Pescado, huevos y verduras.
¿Cuántos niños nacieron del proyecto?
¿Cuántos niños?
215.
200, alimentó a 215 niños.
Sí, bastante.
So, micuna means food in Quechua, but in Spanish this also sounds like my crib. We created this environment for moms to feel safe and talk to and share their problems and ask questions they may have been having and questioning themselves for a while, but they were afraid of asking their doctor.
You can also hear the gender over here, it's a female. The nose and the little mouth over here.
Is yawning.
Yeah.
¿Cómo se dice?
Bostezo.
Bostezo.
Está bostezando.
There's a part of the brain called the ganglio-thalamic ovoid, which is like an egg. And it's the one that we think will be, could be responsive to nutrition.
We used field-friendly technology for ultrasound to look at brain development and measure for changes in different regions of the brain based on diet. That's the scientific aspect we're interested in. But more importantly, we want that child to thrive, to show improved developmental outcomes. We use a tool called the Hammersmith Neonatal Neurological Exam. It's an assessment for reflex, motor, muscle control, the development domains you can measure in a newborn that are the result of brain health.
One of the favorite parts of the research is being in the community and being with the participants. I love public health as a discipline. But one critique I might make about public health would be that we focus on populations. We think about populations all the time. And we can forget about the humans who exist in those populations. So, here I get emotional. This week has been about the humans and understanding who they are and interacting with them and their children and seeing some of the challenges that they face on day-to-day life.
El pescado tiene la ventaja de que ayuda al desarrollo y el cerebro es el que nos ayuda a pensar, a producir.
I was very happy to see that we can help the communities and work together with the Ministry of Health and other people from the communities to make a difference in women's health. Nutritional information is contributing not only on improving the mother's health, but also is improving the knowledge of the importance of consumption of animal proteins, fruits, vegetables.
Hola, Prito. Bien, el proyecto también nos enseñaban a cómo preparar los alimentos, cómo lavarlos para que nos rinda, o sea, de mejor manera para nuestra salud. Entonces, más que un proyecto llamado Mi Cuna, fue un proyecto de vida, de dar vida.
It's also about elevating women's voice and allowing mothers to have agency in their child care and the ability to raise their children in a healthy way. It's universal. Across the world, most mothers want the best for their children.
Thank you.
Thank you.